What our telescopes can capture are very high resolution temperature maps of the Earth. So this is at a global scale to tackle global challenges. So for example, you can use these temperature maps to monitor energy efficiency in buildings to reduce carbon emissions. Or even it can act as an early warning system to detect wildfires and prevent natural disasters. Now we're capturing thermal images with these telescopes, which we believe will be the next big data set in Earth observation. And what we're aiming to do is to be one of the key players in the thermal imaging market. So traditionally, what users of satellite images, what they wanted is optical images. They wanted them at a high resolution and at a high frequency as well for many applications. But now we're starting to see that users want to use different data sets. Now we're capturing thermal images with these telescopes, which we believe will be the next big data set in Earth observation. And what we're aiming to do is to be one of the key players in the thermal imaging market. We've been focusing on looking at thermal inefficiency in buildings in different cities. And this has been supported by the UK Space Agency. So what we're doing is capturing drone images in Cambridge of different buildings to look, basically have a poor energy efficiency, and working with partners such as the University of Cambridge or the Cambridge City Council to study how these insights from the images can be used to reduce carbon emissions. So for example, if you see a building with poor energy efficiency, you can retrofit it to increase its efficiency and reduce the carbon emissions of the overall city. So 30% of global carbon emissions comes from the built environment. So that's where we're really focusing on this area. And with thermal images, you can really detect the highest emitters at a global scale. So not only in an individual city such as Cambridge, you can target cities all around the world. Climate change is not going to get better anytime soon. You'll see that there will be more droughts, more natural disasters. And with technology such as our telescope, you can actually monitor its progression over time, which will be key for scientists studying climate change, but also decision makers making policies to help reduce the effects of climate change. Climate change is definitely the biggest problem that current generation is facing. So I'm sure that there will be more businesses and more technologies focusing on how to mitigate this problem and how to tackle this global challenge. So one of our early challenges was to demonstrate the benefits of thermal imaging. And it's very difficult to demonstrate to the users why thermal imaging is useful if you don't have an actual image to show. Right now, satellites capturing thermal images in space, the resolution is too poor to understand why they're useful. So we started operating a thermal imaging drone here in Cambridge. We started capturing different images of buildings, of farms, to study different applications and stitching these images together and downgrading the resolution to demonstrate what our telescope can capture and what sort of benefits or insights users can get from using our images. We see our telescope and drones as complementary technologies, because the main advantage with satellite imaging is that you can do it at a global scale. It's a global picture. You can see all cities around the world. With drone imaging, it has a very limited scale, but it's a very fine detail. So you can even use the telescope to capture a global temperature map and really zoom into the different cities or buildings using drones.